So, hello everybody. Here I am with Ben Furman. It's a great honor. Hi, Ben.
Hi.
Ben is a psychiatrist and psychotherapist. He's a brief therapist and is very famous in Finland, but also in the rest of the world. He wrote over than 20 books about brief therapy, in particular about kids therapy and kids skill. We will talk about that in a moment. And he is the founder of the Helsinki Brief Therapy Institute, and he also studied in Italy with Boscolo and Checkin. That was great. Yeah, cool. The Milan School of Mara Salvini Palazzoli. And he also had a TV program with over 200 episodes, yeah, right? Okay, so it's a very great honor to me to have you here, Ben. And
My honor, my honor.
you're too kind. So, are we ready?
Yes.
Okay, so the very first question before talking about kids' skill, it's that there is a very interesting thing about you. You start with long-term therapy. You start studying psychoanalysis, if I understood, right? Yeah.
In my country, in Finland, when I became a psychiatrist, that's many years ago. It's like 200 years ago or something. And I started to study psychiatry. At that time, everybody was going to become a psychoanalyst. It was at that time the dominant discourse, like they say. So all my colleagues wanted to become psychoanalysts, and I thought I would also need to become a psychoanalyst in order to take myself seriously as a psychiatrist. But at the same time, new trends started to come into our field, and one of those trends was family therapy.
In fact, then you go to study brief therapy. And so the question is, we can't do brief therapy with kids. And what are the characteristics of brief therapy with kids?
I think that the characteristics is the same. Instead of saying brief therapy, we might even say that there's a different philosophy of solving human problems. It maybe comes from Milton Erickson. It's maybe refined by the people at MRI Mental Research Institute, Paul Watzlawick and his team. They started to develop this kind of a new way of thinking that, may I say, is not interested in why people have problems, is more interested in what is maintaining problems, what is keeping people stuck in problems, what perhaps not so good attempted solutions they are using, and if we can change the way we approach problems, and more recently, if we can change the way we talk about problems, we can maybe solve problems much more effectively than we used to do when we were so interested in finding out what is causing the problem.
So, what are for you a good way to help kids in brief time, in few sessions?
I think I can answer that because when we use the brief therapy model to work with kids, we actually speak very little about their problems. We don't analyze problems, we don't diagnose children, we approach them differently. And I like to say we approach them with a skills mindset, if that's possible to say like that. Skills mindset. So when you look at the child who has a problem from the skills mindset point of view, you are not seeing a child with a problem. You're seeing a child who needs to develop some skill. You're more aware of what skill is missing for that child, what skill that child needs to learn in order not to behave like that. So your whole thinking is much in the realm of skills. When I talk with parents, I say, what skill do you think your child needs to learn? When I look at the child, I go like, what skill do you think you need to learn so you will be happy and it will be fun for you to be in school? And if I talk to this teacher, it will be the same question. So in a way, my job becomes to be a teacher. In a way, I'm a teacher. I'm teaching people how to think about children's problems, and I'm teaching a kind of a mindset that I like to call it skills mindset. Because when you shift from talking about problems and you start to talk about skills, it changes the way the mind operates. People become more optimistic. Why? Because, you know, you can learn, you can always learn skills. Children want to collaborate. They start to have ideas. If you then start to say, okay, so how can you learn that skill? So suddenly children are participating in the conversation. Parents have some idea. I can even ask daddy, how did you learn that skill? Or I can ask mommy, are you good at that skill? Can you teach your child to learn the same skill? So in a way, when we say brief therapy, it doesn't really capture the essence. It's maybe better not to speak about brief therapy, but another way of approaching children's problems that I think maybe we should call it skills mindset or something.
Yeah.